Cynthia Loretta Haynes, aged 77, late of Draxhall Woods, St. George, retired worker of the London-born daycare nursery, active participant of Q in the community, daughter of the late Elaine and Cyril Haynes, sister of Mildred King, Vendal and Clarine Haynes, the late Daphne Smith, Winifred Hunt, Elkanah, Lionel, and Myrtle Haynes, aunt of Ivan Walcott, Diana, Kenneth, Richard, Peter, and Yvette Hunt, Shelley, Dawn, Brian and Michael Haynes, Jennifer and Ian King, Leah and Lamar Ford, and many others. Great aunt of Jacqueline Shepherd, Richard Walcott, and many others. Cousin of Andrew Goodridge, Margaret Coppin, and many others. Friend of Colleen Griffith, and many others. Relative of the Gittins, Goodridge, Evelyn, and Bascom families. The funeral of Cynthia Loretta Haynes leaves the Belmont Funeral Home on Tuesday, March 5th, 2024, for St. Luke's Anglican Church, Brighton, St. George, where relatives and friends are asked to meet at 3 p.m. for the service and interment. The service and burial may be viewed via live stream at www.belmontfuneralhome.live/Cynthia Haynes.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning, it's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul.
When my strength is failing, the end draws near, and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord.
a place where mercy reigns and never dies. There's a place where streams of grace flow deep and wide, where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you, I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you, I owe all to you, Jesus. There's a place where sin and shame are powerless, where my heart has peace with God and forgiveness, where all the love I've ever
The Lord be with you. Please stand. Almighty Almighty God and our Heavenly Father, we thank you for another time, another opportunity, Lord, to come into your house, to hear your holy word read and preached. We thank you, our loving Father God, for your presence among us. We thank you, Lord, for lips to sing your praises. We thank you, Lord, for all your blessings. We thank you at this time, Lord God, that for the gift of life, the precious gift of life, as we celebrate that of our departed sister. Father God, we thank you for her and the contribution that she made to our lives. And we pray, loving Father God, as we come to celebrate, that we remember, Lord God, that this is an act of worship to you, to sing your praises, to be reverenced before you, and to worship you in spirit and in truth. And Lord, without this, without you, we cannot do this. So we invite you, your presence, Lord God, among us, even though we know that you are always among us. And we thank you, O loving Father, for your guidance and your grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our sister Cynthia Loretta for burial. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Cynthia. Father God, we thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Rest eternal, grant unto her, O Lord.
Our first hymn, Come Ye That Love the Lord.
Thank you. city of God. The heavenly fields before we reach, the heavenly fields are warm. The golden streets are warm, the golden streets. We're marching to Zion, beautiful, beautiful Zion. Abound, and every tear be dry. We're marching through Emmanuel's ground. We're marching through Emmanuel's ground to fairer walls on high, to fair. We're marching through Emmanuel's ground. We're marching through Emmanuel's ground to fairer walls on high, to fairer. We are marching to Zion.
Person that printed this left out a verse.
At this time, we'll have the eulogy by Jennifer King.
Eulogy of Cynthia Loretta Haynes. Just be yourself. Embrace your uniqueness, individuality, and complexities. Be yourself. For it's stated in Psalms 149 that you are fearful and wonderfully made. Cynthia Loretta Haynes certainly displayed this concept every day. Her uniqueness and individuality were the essence of her character and was readily seen in her appearance and her actions. With her large afro and gentle mannerisms, she pursued her many passions and charted her life the way she wanted it. Her life began in Draxall Woods, St. George, where she was born to the parents of Eileen and Serlene Haynes. Oh, Lord, what I said. Cyril Haynes. Granddad would. She was the seventh child out of nine children and had been deceased by five siblings. Daphne Doris Smith, Winifred Cynthia Haynes Hunt, Elkanah Johnny, Lionel Hartboy, and Myrtle Haynes. I say this this way because I saw their government names, and at my age is when I learned them. So I wanted to say the names that I know them as. cherishing her memories are her other siblings, Mildred Ruby King, and another sister, Clarine Rose Haynes, and one brother, Vendel Haynes. Growing up, she and her siblings worshiped right here at St. Luke's Anglican, and as an adult, she continued to attend church regularly. During her young adult life, she was employed in various fields, such as in sales, garment factory employee, and then went on to work as a cook at a number of government day nurseries. Her last assignment was the London-born day nursery, from where she retired. Auntie Cinti was foremost embraced her uniqueness. She was Cynthia Haynes, no more, no less. True to herself and never tried to fit in. And I reiterate, she was always herself. Complex, gentle, entertaining, bold and yet reserved, unique and outspoken. And boy, was she outspoken. She stood for no nonsense. She had no difficulty calling a spade a spade. Her brother recalls that to emphasize her point, she would often remark, "Common sense isn't common, you know." Family members recounted having to make sure when interacting with her that all their T's were crossed and their I's dotted. However, it's noted that she expressed her opinion but never held any bitterness against anyone. Like all of us, she had her interests and one of her greatest pleasures was gardening. She was a workhorse outside. She spent countless hours landscaping her surroundings. Her environment was always colorful and pristine. She would work late into the evening, chopping, digging, hoeing, and whatever it took to transform her project into the scenery she desired. Cutting through walls that were in her way, just like the advertisement, she, in her own little way, without heavy equipment, moved the earth to please. Thursday, yes, Thursday, that was the day that she so much anticipated. Whenever Q in the community was held, she was there. On numerous occasions, she experienced difficulty getting the bus from her area. Her nephew recalls that on more than one occasion, she would stop him with, "I got to get to Q. The bus is plenty full." And then she would effortlessly climb into the truck, the tall truck, saying, "I know you ain't going my way, but I got to get to Q." Auntie was often referred to as the lady from Q, for she enjoyed dancing there. During her hospitalization, one of her relatives said to her, "Today is Thursday. And if you were well, you know where you would be." A huge smile lit up her face. As a matter of fact, that smile went from ear to ear, and although in pain, she said, "I miss Q." At Q, she danced the music that she wanted to and had a preference for oldie goldies and a special liking for RPB and grinder songs. She danced the way she wanted to and could not be influenced by what types of dance others were engaged in. She enjoyed her type of dancing and was satisfied with her efforts. Apart from Q, she made a tradition of attending the fairs organized by this church. As a matter of fact, she often said that she never missed a fair at St. Luke's. She participated to the fullest and made sure she enjoyed herself. Her passions and interests were not limited to gardening and dancing. Auntie Cynthia was a philanthropist side to her. She had a special affiliation for persons less fortunate, especially those who were homeless. From all reports, she would make it a commitment to feed the homeless. It is said that on Fridays and Saturdays, she would leave home with at least 3 bags that could be filled with prepared foods from which she distributed to the homeless, especially in Queen's Park and the Garrison Savannah. This she did for years. She never talked about it or highlighted it in any form or fashion. Her generosity, she never highlighted her generosity to the less fortunate. As I conclude this eulogy, I must refer to another integral part of Auntie's life, clothing and fashion. She loved wearing what pleased her and had great affection for African wear. She has amassed an extensive collection of African dresses along with the matching hair pieces, which she would proudly wear in recognition of her African heritage. This was one of our lasting memories of her. Today we lay our loved one to rest. Her life will live in the memory of her siblings, Ruby, Vendel, and Rose, her nephew, Ivan Walcott, many other nephews and nieces, great and great-great nieces and nephews, cousins and friends. Rest in peace, Auntie.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Bible reading to be read by Margaret Coppin. Good evening. A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 to 7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord. The appointed Psalm, Psalm 23, and following will be the second Bible reading by Abigail Hunt.
reading from the Word of God written in St. John chapter 5, verses 24 to 27. Very truly, I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes in him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. Very truly, I tell you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. The word of the Lord.
The hymn before the homily, And Can It Be?
Thank you.
won't sing this 10 times this evening. Huh? We won't sing this hymn 10 times this evening. I speak to you in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please sit. Death is something people tend to think very little about until someone close to us dies. And I believe personally that many people fear death because they don't know what happens next. There's only one source that reveals the truth about what happens after death, and that source is who or what? The Word of God, the Holy Bible, Holy Scripture. Hebrews 9:27 says, "It is appointed unto man once to die, and after this, the judgment." Death, my brothers and sisters in Christ, is something that we will all face when our time comes. But death need not be fearful for those who believe and trust in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who died for our sins, was buried, and on the third day rose again according to the Word of God. The Bible is clear on the subject of death and eternal life. And John 5:39 tells us that Jesus said, "You study the scriptures diligently because you think that in them you have eternal life. These are the very scriptures that testify about me, yet you refuse to come to me to have life." Scripture teaches us that it is wonderful to do good works, but our good works cannot earn us a place in heaven. Ephesians 2:8-9 tells us, "For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourself. It is what? The gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." Everyone has to answer for themselves before God, and it is not my place nor yours to judge. The Bible does say it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, and we should be prepared to meet God in this lifetime and not wait until it is too late. When we think of it, funerals, in a sense, are more for the living than they are for the deceased. We are certainly here to pay our respects, to celebrate the wonderful memories of our sister Cynthia. But consider this: Cynthia is no longer a part of this world of chaos and sorrow and confusion. But we are. She's not in pain today, but many of us are. She's not fearful nor anxious of what is to come, but there are some of us here who are. And I don't know what relationship Cynthia Loretta had with God, but what I can say is that if she had a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, then we can be assured that she will experience that promised everlasting life, everlasting peace, and everlasting joy, which has been promised to those who are children of God and trust in Him by faith. Without the grace of God, without our blessed hope, brothers and sisters, what do we have? Just a few short years upon this earth to eat and drink and enjoy the fruit of our labor, as Solomon in his book of Ecclesiastes writes. But even these pleasures, Solomon himself noted, are from the hand of God. And the essence of the gospel is not only the life of Christ, it is also about the death of Christ. The life of Christ, as we read the gospels, we find that his life was truly amazing in every way. What did he do? He taught and preached God's word. He fed the hungry. He healed the sick. He drove out demons and delivered those in bondage. He gave sight to the blind. He made the dumb speak. He even raised the dead. But brothers and sisters, it is his own death that gives us hope. For he died as a sacrifice for sin. And on the third day he rose again, conquering death. And not only for himself, but for all who would believe. In John chapter 11, before Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead, what did he say to Martha? Jesus said to her, I am the what? The resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, they will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. And he asked her, do you believe this? And I want to ask us the same question. Do we believe what Jesus said? Oh, yes. I'm so glad to hear that. Oh, yes. A lot of people sit down and they don't answer. Huh? But we as Christians, man, we as the people of God, the body of Christ, we ought to be ready, always ready with a testimony. Huh? People come in here so and get on half day. Anything about God, we should be ready to get up and testify and to talk about what he's done for us. I saw a lady today on YouTube, and she sang Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. She sang it about 10 times in 10 different tunes. And you could see how she praised God through that hymn. Yeah? I would love to see people in church doing that. Instead of singing half dead, some mouth don't even open to utter the words. But I mean, I admired her. She sang her heart out. She raised her hands about 10 different tunes to that one hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Brothers and sisters, we have to manifest Jesus in us every day. We have to do it more, because there are people out there who have lost faith. They have lost hope, and we need to reassure them again. Encourage them. Yeah? The forgiveness of sins and everlasting life is not something reserved for the most holy among us. It's not even an issue of how good we are or what sins we have or have not committed. The main issue is this: are we willing to confess our sins and ask God for forgiveness? Are we willing to repent and believe Jesus Christ for salvation? That is a decision, brothers and sisters, that all of us need to make for ourselves. And I want to tell you this evening that we need to make it as soon as possible. Funerals also remind us of how short life is and how important it is to keep a right relationship with one another. Because once that person has slipped away from us, we can never again tell them how much we love them or how much we appreciated all that they did for us. We should all tell those whom we love how much they mean to us while we have the opportunity. Life is short, and it is far too short to ever withhold forgiveness from those who have done us wrong. All of us have lost loved ones, and it is never easy, no matter how many years they were with us. Many people know that life is short. And if we look around even Barbados, if we look around our communities, if we look around the world, people live their lives as though they belong to the cat species. You know, when I was growing up, we used to hear that a cat had 9 lives. That is true? Eh? But some of us live as though we have 9 lives. Some people act as if life is always about to begin, or as if they have all the time in the world. Some act as if the real part of our life is on the way, but first we have some things to do. We have some unfinished business. We have debts to pay. We have a responsibility to take care of. And then when we have accomplished all that, then life will begin. Some of us act as if we have time put down because we want to live our lives according to our own standards or the world's standards, and then turn to God in our old age. When we retire, when we feel that we have accomplished all that we set out to accomplish, when we feel comfortable with a nice house and a car and some money in the bank, and our children are all grown up, and then we say, yes, well, I can come and serve God now. And although sometimes we have all this, and we retire, we have the house and the money and everything else, but we forget all about the goodness of God and would rather spend our time at Q in the community or liming at a rum shop or just gossiping every day on the phone with like Lottie and Mabel. You remember that show, that thing on radio some time ago? Lottie and Mabel? Or even sitting down home listening to Brass Tacks. Because we ain't got no interest nor time with God nor his church. And a lot of people make excuses for not going to church by pointing fingers at the people in the church. But I want to say, brothers and sisters, all of we are sinners. All of us. All of us have sinned. All of us want to get to heaven. And some of us have to try harder than others. All of us are at different spiritual levels. So yes, there might got hypocrites in the church. But I want you to know that when the Lord comes again, he's not going to ask you about them. He's going to ask you about you. So we need not be concerned of if this body is a hypocrite and they're always in the church. They may be struggling with the faith, but yes, they're here, they're trying. Where are you? I want to refer here to a parable that Jesus told. Do you remember the parable Jesus told when he said, a man and his servant went out to sow seeds of wheat. And they did sow those seeds, but when they returned, they found that the wheat had sprung up. But what happened? There were also tares. In other words, we used to call them pimplers or thorns. And the servant said, but master, should I pull them up? Should I pull up the tares? And what did the master say? No, lest when you pull up the tares, the wheat comes up with them. Yet leave them until the harvest time. Then they will be separated. Yeah? And we know, yes, perhaps everybody that comes to church, whenever the church they're open, might not see heaven. But we don't have to worry about them. It is you. It is about you, yourself, and your relationship with God. And I would encourage anybody to join God's church, to come into God's house. I would encourage anybody, wherever you go, whichever church you go to. James 4:14 tells us, you do not know what your life will be like tomorrow. You are just a vapor that appears for a little while and then vanishes away. And then 1 Peter 1:24 tells us all flesh is like what? Grass. And all its glory like the flower of grass. The grass withers and the flower falls. We recognize how wrong it is to throw away a life in one instance. We have a lot to say about persons who commit suicide or they throw their life away, or people who die in accidents because they were drinking alcohol and yet driving. And yet we don't see how sinful it is to do the same thing, to throw our lives away hour by hour and day by day. Brothers and sisters, life can be wasted hour by hour, day by day, year by year, and in thousands of ways. For example, we find that people with diabetes, we eat what we are not supposed to. We waste our time at school, young people. And then at the end of the day, we have no qualifications for a job. We waste time sitting and waiting for the job we want. We drink all the rum and whiskey. We get drunk. We smoke, uncaring of our health. We forgetting that this body that God has given us is His temple, the temple of the Holy Spirit. We follow our peers, and we get involved in drugs, and we die a slow death. And I say this all the time. You may hear me at funerals repeating things, but there are things that I'm so concerned about. I'm concerned about the young men. Everywhere you go, everywhere you turn, you see young men, and I sometimes I wonder if they look in the mirror and they look at their faces. You know? I wonder. Everywhere you go, you could see, even you see the young people, some not only young people, hardback adults too. You walk in the street, they're going to work, and they got a spliff. I mean, we used to complain about the cigarettes, but now it's some bad smelling things. I don't know. I don't even know how they could stand the scent. Yeah? We know that feeling of making poor choices. Some of us make them deliberately. We waste time, and we throw our lives away, and we don't care. We need to be mindful that life, this life, is short. We only have, the word of God says, 70 years, 70 years and 10. Some of us don't even live to get there. Yeah? We need to be mindful that life is too short. And when we recognize that we need to change. We need to intend to live a new life. Some never get around to that. We shouldn't give ourselves away to things that are less than God's best, or surrender ourselves to the world's values. Because life is short, brothers and sisters. Many of us have not figured that out yet. And we act like we have forever to live. We need to stop procrastinating. We need to stop putting off the decision to turn away from our selfish goals and the sins of this world, and surrender to the one who loves us like nobody else can. And He has in mind for us what is best for us. No matter who we are or how sinful we are, God wants the best for us. The value of our lives is not to be measured by our bank account, not by how we look, not by our standing in our communities, not even in the amount of good that we have done. But the value of our lives is simply this, that God values us highly enough to give us joy. We are called today, brothers and sisters in Christ, to live God's way. The way in which, by faith, forgiveness will triumph over revenge and hope over despair and joy over sorrow, generosity over stinginess, love over apathy, life over death, and reconciliation over separation. Life is too short to ignore the Creator. Life is too short to skip church or to leave good words unsaid, to spend so much time glued to our cell phones. A pastor man up there had to say, "Lord, years ago, you will never see that." I mean, the technology they're here. But, I mean, even the people in the driving the tractors, and they're taking a break, cell phone. People even go in the bathroom with a cell phone. But we need to spend, we need to stop spending so much time on these things that are not important. Watching television, wasting time on the block, and so little time or none at all carrying out Jesus' mission. And brothers and sisters, all of us have been given that mission. Life is short, so celebrate God's eternity, his gift of eternity. Make time for the things that matter. Don't leave yourself regretting things you didn't do. And as I said, be an evangelist. Tell a friend how God's love has changed your life. There are people out there that need to know because they need hope. Be a person who talks about Jesus in your conversations. Develop your prayer life. And Lent, the season, this season of the church's year, Lent, we need to do a lot of that. Develop our prayer lives. Believe in Jesus Christ with all your heart and your soul and your mind and your strength. Celebrate God's love. Because, brothers and sisters, we do not have all the time in the world. Life is like a journey on a train. I came across this, and I would have read it some time ago at a couple of funerals, but it says so much. Life is like a journey on a train with its stations, change of routes, differing scenes and accidents. At birth, we boarded the train and met our parents. And we believe that they would always travel at our side. However, at some station down the line, our parents stepped off, leaving the train and us alone to continue on our own. As time passed, other people boarded the train, and they were significant. Siblings, friends, children, and even the love of our life. Many will step down and leave a permanent vacuum. Others will go unnoticed that we didn't realize that they had vacated their seats. This train ride will be full of sorrow, joy, fantasy, expectations, hellos, goodbyes, and farewells. Success consists of having a good relationship with all the passengers, requiring that we give the best of ourselves. The mystery to everyone is we don't know at which station we ourselves will be asked to step off. So we must live in the best way, love, forgive, and offer the best of ourselves until it comes our time to exit, leaving our seat empty. We should leave behind beautiful memories for those who will continue riding the train of life without us. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we live in a world that is constantly changing. In life, we will go through many seasons, but we can rely on one thing to remain constant and unchangeable. God does not change. Malachi 3:6 says, "For I, the Lord, do not change." Hebrews 13:8 says, "Jesus Christ is the same man yesterday, today, and forever." And this means that we can be sure of God's promises. He will not change his mind about us. He loves us forever. There's a time for change, therefore, and a time appointed to all of us. There's a time appointed to everything. God is in control of all things. And he has given his promise of salvation to those who believe in his Son. There will come a time when this earth and heaven will pass away. The word of God says that. And a new earth and a new heaven will come. Brothers and sisters, if you would be there, now is the time to live our lives according to God's word. So many things are happening around us. So many things. And when we look at it, let me tell you, I'm going to go and read the book of Revelation here. Go and read it. And then look around at the things that are happening across this world. My prayer for each one here today is that you may sense God's love for you and his desire to hold you even during this time and any other time that you are facing challenges or going through difficult times. And that all of us may come to know the Lord Jesus Christ. And brothers and sisters, not just know about him, but know him. Have a personal relationship with him so that we can experience that peace that surpasses all understanding when this world continues to be chaotic around us. Our dear sister, Cynthia, has come to the end of her journey in this world. The rest of us here still have a way to go. Whether it is a couple minutes, we don't know. Whether it is an hour, a day, a week, a year, or many years to come. But let us be mindful that we have one another to cling to and the everlasting arms of our blessed Savior to lean on. And I want to encourage family and friends of Cynthia to draw closer together, especially during this time of bereavement, and other times too. Be the comfort for somebody else in your family. Yeah, there are too many dysfunctional families across the world in our community. Up to, it was last week, when two cousins fought and one ended up dead. Yeah, we need to build back our families. Rekindle your relationships with each other. But more importantly, lean on Jesus. Remember that he's always present with us. And he's sharing this journey of life, and he brings us fresh hope and new faith while renewing us with his promises of forgiveness, of love, and the promise of eternal life. Brothers and sisters in Christ, now is the appointed time. It is now. Make that decision. Yeah? Huh? We will? And those who are people of faith, encourage the others. And not only those that are here that might not be believers, but others in your community, others in your family. Yeah? We have lost, according to Revelation, many of us have lost our first love. Yeah? Let me get back there. In Beijing, let me get back there. Too many things are happening. Yeah? Amen. Let us stand and reaffirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. It is in your booklets. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please kneel if you can for our prayers. We pray for those who mourn, and we commemorate the departed. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant Cynthia may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, O loving Father, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. O Lord, in your mercy. O loving Father, may we be strengthened in our faith and live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. O Lord, in your mercy. Father, show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope and fill them with the peace and the joy of your presence. O Lord, in your mercy. Father, we commend all people, believers and unbelievers, to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. O Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Cynthia Loretta, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. Father of all, we pray to you for Cynthia and for all those whom we love and see no longer. Father, grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them, and may she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use the right the time that is left to us here on earth. Lord, lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done, and the good we have failed to do. And Lord, strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I take this opportunity on behalf of the Parochial Church Council and the congregation here at St. Luke. We extend our sincerest condolences to the relatives and friends of our departed sister, Cynthia. I always used to, when I see her, go and pat her little afro. And what Jennifer said is true. I was only here for one fair, that was last year, and she danced the whole evening, every tune. I understand she even went and tell the person who was playing the music what tunes to play. But I admired her because it wasn't no walk up nothing. She just moved across that little pasture there. Yeah, so at least we would miss her for that, and our fair is coming up around the corner. We will miss her, yeah? But rest eternal grant unto her. Oh, Lord, it was her time to go. Let light perpetual shine upon her. During the final hymn, we will be taking a collection, and it will go towards the upkeep of the cemetery. So during the singing of our final hymn, we will ask you to contribute to that effort.
The hymn, To God Be the Glory.
He gave us his son. life, atonement for sin, and open the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath done. Great things he hath taught us, great things he hath done, and great our rejoicing through Jesus the Son.
Church, in Jesus' name, amen. Shortly hymns, though. Huh? Why are you going to cut shortly hymns? Okay. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing to him in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Nominatimus.
Depart in peace, abide in the tomb.
Record of their deeds. Man born of woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Cynthia Loretta, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our sister Cynthia and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection, receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer.
Amen.
Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Rest eternal, grant unto her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon her and give her peace. Amen.
all this dust can come up more and they begin to cover.
I thought the sheep was
they're playing?
So how to quiet hand them out there?
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see the fall.
Like a river, a kind of my way. precious Lord, take my hand.
Take my hand. Lead me on. Let me stand. I am tired. I am weak. I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows dim, precious Lord, lead me home.
When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is lost and gone, at the river I stand. Precious Lord, lead me home.
The day thou gavest, Lord, we thank thee.
The day thou gavest, Lord, we thank thee. The darkness was at your request. On sleeping while earth rolls onward into light, through all the world her watch is keeping and rests not now by day or night. As o'er each and island, the dawn is on another day. The voice of prayer is never silent, nor dies the strain of grace away. So be shall never like earth's proud empires pass away. Thy kingdom stands and grows forever till all thy creatures own thy sway.
That's why we want to bring with a hymn book and stop singing from this.
Thank you.
But the hymn has about 5 verses.
Yeah, see, have an auto there.
No. Jesus Christ.
His face shine upon you and be gracious to you.